Welcome to this SharePoint PMP short video. So in this video, we'll have a look on how to exclude libraries from your SharePoint framework bundles. So first of all, what does it actually mean and why you should be aware of this? And how do you then exclude these external libraries from your SharePoint framework solution bundles? And I'll let Waldeck Mastercards to do the demo on this one. Waldeck, take it away.
Thank you. So whenever you add library to your SharePoint framework project, it's being by default included in bundle. So what does it mean? Let's have a look at two web parts that we have built in Angular, and then we have added to Workbench. So let's have a quick look at their size. Let's reload the Workbench. And now we can see that the total size of this page is almost 7 megs. 7 megs, yeah. So and that's only two web parts, right? So with that, let's have a look at the bundle sizes. Let me refresh the page again. And then when we here filter responses to bundles, here we can see two web parts, and each one of them is 1.3 meg. So that means a web part that only shows some images and documents is quite big. So let's have a look why. Let's have a look at like what makes the web part so big. And the great thing is, if we switch back to code, here in the project, there is a temp directory, and in it, there is a stats directory where there's a page that you can open in browser, and it shows exactly what's inside the bundle. So let's do exactly that. Let's pull this one here, and let me switch that one here and drag it here to browser. And now we can see when we pick one of the web parts, let me zoom that in a bit. When we pick one of the web parts, we can now see that it proves that it is 1.3 megs. And here we can see each of these rings represents dependency that we include in bundle. So first one here is node modules, which is where all of the bundles or all of the dependencies that we reference comes from. And if we move up a ring, now we can see that it's Angular. So in other words, we now embed Angular, all of it, into the web part, and that takes by itself a meg. So now you know why, right? We have two web parts on a page, and each of them embeds Angular. So that's why we're not only we load Angular twice, but we actually download it also in browser. So that slows down loading the page a lot. So what can we do about that? Well, the great thing is that in SPFX, you can really easily say that dependency that you want to use is external one. And you don't want to include it in bundle, but you actually want to load it from a URL. And you can do that in code. So when we switch to code, you can do that in the config directory, config.json, and there is a section called externals. And actually, the best part is that when you choose to load dependency from a URL, you don't need to change anything about your code. The code stays exactly the same. You only say that dependency X should be actually pulled from a URL and not included in bundle. So in our case, as we use Angular, let's define this for Angular. So the way it works is that first you say Angular, because that's the name of the dependency. And now you have two ways in going around it. So first is that you could say here the URL, which is HTTP some CDN. Or another one is you say it like that, and you say first path, and then the URL. And then here you also define the global name. And that would be for Angular. So how do you know which of these you would use? Well, it depends. It depends on the format of your script that you want to load. Different scripts are being built in a different way, right? There are modules and just non-module scripts that are being just written as a flat list of script. Right, and depending which format you want to use, you have to use either the first format with only the URL or the one that you see now on the screen. So the first thing is you have to know which format the script that you are trying to reference is in, right? And the only way to do that is if you would get the URL. So here, let's get a URL to Angular from CDN, open that in browser, and then see if you can figure out the format of the script from here. You probably can't. I cannot do it either. So to make it easier, there's a free tool that you can use available at rancor.com/sharepoint-framework/script-check, which is here, and we will include that URL in notes. And the great thing about it is it's free to use, and the only thing that you have to do is to paste the URL, get it analyzed, and then you will know not only the format, but you will also get the exact snippet of code that you have to use in project. So we can just grab that, go back to our externals part, put it here, format it, and then change my library to Angular, and we're done, right? So with that, we have exactly the right type of code, because otherwise, you would probably have to try one, see if it works. If it does not, you would have to try another one, and that's not really an efficient way to go around it. All right, so with that, we defined Angular as an external script. How about we rebuild the project? We stop that. We say go bundle to actually rebundle the project. And then what we can do is we can analyze the stats and see how much things improved. So remember, initially we had 1.3 megs per web part. Now if we go here and we refresh the generated stats, you can now see that the web parts is actually 32K each. So with that, we went from 1.3 megs to 32K per web part just by defining Angular as an external resource. And that's definitely a thing that you should keep in mind, right? Because it helps you slim down the web parts that you use on your intranet. And actually, the best part is, if you choose to use exactly the same location for all your script, you will be able to slim down the size of the whole intranet a lot, right? Because you will pull down Angular or jQuery or Knockout or anything else that you use once. It will be cached. And then the only thing that will be actually pulled down is the web part itself. So with that, you will improve how fast things load a lot.